Hello HFA 澳洲揾食，咁又嚟到跳出悉尼嘅时间啦。咁前几集呢已经介绍过去悉尼嘅北边同埋悉尼嘅南边啦。咁睇吧，今次呢都要去悉尼嘅西边睇睇。咁未出发先兴奋啊，咁梗係要搵笪地方依下肚先嘅。咁我哋呢就嚟到呢个堡垒山呢个商场 Castle Towers 嗰度呢搵啲嘢食啦。咁呢个商场好大，好多嘢行㗎噃，但係更加多嘅呢就係有好多呢啲澳洲式嘅 cafe。咁我哋呢今日就嚟到呢一间叫做 Flower Child 嘅 cafe 食啲嘢先嘅。咁睇嚟今日都有几多人喺度排队喎，而里面当然係坐满晒食客啦。咁等咗一阵之后呢，店员就带我哋入座啦。咁之后呢，我哋点嘅食物好快都嚟啦。首先呢个呢就係炒蛋多士，嗰塊多士熱辣辣叫味㗎，係烧到嚟㗎噃。咁试食专员呢就染选咗呢个汉堡包加薯条嘅。咁食饱饱之后呢，我哋就真係出发啦。咁由堡垒山向西边行呢，揸个零钟头嘅车程呢，就会去到我哋今日第一个目的地㗎啦。今日天气梗係好好啦。咁我哋第一个目的地呢，就係我哋今次旅程要下榻嘅酒店嗰度嘅。睇嚟呢间酒店都几大喎。而乍眼睇咧，呢间酒店嘅装修咧，应该系以木为主题嘅。咁今次呢一间咧，个名就叫做 Fairmont Resort Blue Mountains。其实呢，佢係一间度假村酒店嚟㗎。咁我哋即刻喺柜位嗰度做个登记先。咁之后呢，就去我哋嘅房间摆低啲行李先。我哋今次係住四楼嘅。呢间就系我哋嘅房间啦，即刻入去做一个 room tour 先。间酒店嘅房间咧就唔系好大嘅，咁但系望出去个 view 咧都系几靓噶，望住成个森林同埋山景。咁而浴室方面咧都系简简单单咁啦。最紧要呢就係乾乾淨淨咁就得㗎啦。好啦，睇完间房之后呢，即刻行去酒店第二啲地方睇下先。而家见到呢一个呢就係一个酒吧位置嚟嘅。睇嚟酒吧出面都有啲地方行下㗎喎，咁我哋又即刻出去睇睇先。 前面有啲人戴住头盔咁，究竟有咩玩呢？原来呢度咧就系一条彩虹跑道喎。咁系点玩嘅呢？只要戴咗头盔同埋坐喺呢啲大嘅车胎嗰度咧，就可以滑落去噶啦。咁除此之外咧，呢度都有一个溜冰场噶噃。即刻又行去个溜冰场睇睇先。睇嚟有好多后生仔已经等住入场啦。入面嘅环境都几特别㗎噃。真係勾起返好多儿时回忆啊，踩 roller 同埋踩冰咁样。咁如果唔鍾意溜冰嘅话呢，外面仲有一个泳池嘅。除咗个室外泳池之外呢，里面仲有一个室内嘅泳池嘅。咁如果两样都唔鍾意呢，就可以嚟呢个位置打下机都得嘅。见到呢就有啲赛车机啦，另外有啲波子机。呢度仲有一个室内运动场喎，应该係俾啲小朋友玩㗎啦。咁如果唔鍾意室内呢，仲可以去室外呢个地方玩下啦。咁今次主要嚟南山嘅目的呢，就係睇秋天嘅红叶嘅。咁淨係睇度假村里面呢，已经有好多红树同埋红叶啦。喺呢个度假村里面呢，仲有网球场同埋篮球场。如果唔中意嘅话咧，仲可以去呢个小型迷宫或者动动脑筋捉翻一盘国际象棋都得嘅。咦？呢度好似仲有一只马喎，原来系一个雕塑嚟噶。好啦，行完度假村之后呢，天色尚早，咁我哋就揸车出到去附近嘅 Town Center Katoomba 呢度睇睇啦。咁我以前都嚟过呢度㗎啦，我记得呢度呢有一间好特别好靓嘅酒店㗎噃。应该穿过呢个树丛咧，就见到噶啦，就系呢一间啦。喺呢间酒店嘅装修几特别噶，我谂呢间酒店咧都有一定嘅历史噶啦。又带大家睇下佢哋个餐厅位置里面点先。呢间酒店咧，真系俾我咧有感觉到咧，好似嗰出电影《时光倒流70年》嘅感觉啊！咁之后咧，我哋就行下 Katoomba 嘅大街啦。 呢间铺头都几得意喎。除咗有好多得意嘅铺头之外咧，另外有啲横街都几特别噶。大家见到地下嗰啲枯叶咧，就知道悉尼嘅秋天已经来临啦。行完市中心之后咧，个天色都开始昏暗啦。咁我哋咧又即刻翻酒店嗰度食嘢啦。今晚嘅晚餐咧就会喺酒店呢度食嘅。咁今朝见到个酒吧位置咧，夜晚就会摇身一变变咗一间 grill bar 噶啦。但系今次咧，我只系影咗啲相啫。咁至於食物方面呢，大家睇啲相都可以感覺到啦，我就認為呢係普普通通囉。咁總括嚟講呢，第一日嚟到 Blue Mountain 呢個度假村酒店呢，我就覺得個環境真係幾靚啦，要嚟手機打卡當然一流啦。咁我哋今次旅程呢就會停喺 Blue Mountain 兩日嘅，咁第二日嘅旅程我哋會去到邊呢？咁大家就拭目以待啦。好啦，呢条片暂时去到呢度。如果中意呢条片嘅朋友，记得俾个 like、share 条片出去，俾啲 comment 同埋揿埋个钟仔。咁如果仲未订阅 HFA 澳洲揾食嘅朋友咧，咁就要快啲订阅呢个频道啦。仲要记得 follow 埋我个 Instagram， 而家我都开埋小红书噶啦，大家敬请关注埋我小红书添。咁我哋下一集 Blue Mountain 之旅再继续一齐出去玩啦，拜拜。